Hello, thank you for watching our video about inheritance. I'm a member of the Genome Connect and ClinGen Patient Data Sharing Program team. Each of us have millions and millions of cells that make up our bodies. Our cells contain structures called chromosomes that are made up of our genetic information, or our DNA. Chromosomes keep our genetic information packaged into our cells. DNA is our body's instruction manual, telling our bodies how to develop and function. Each person typically has two copies of each chromosome, except for the X and Y chromosomes. Individuals assigned male at birth are typically XY, and individuals assigned female at birth are most often XX. The DNA in our chromosomes is different for every person. These changes to our DNA are called variants. Many variants do not change the way our cells and bodies function or impact our health, but some do. Changes in our DNA can be passed on from a parent to a child, or they can be unique to an individual. If a variant is passed from a parent to a child, it is said to be inherited. For example, an individual with a variant that causes Duchenne muscular dystrophy, a disease that affects the muscles, can pass the variant to their child. If their child also has the variant, they may also go on to have Duchenne muscular dystrophy. If a variant is unique to the child and has not been passed down from a parent, this variant is called de novo. We call these de novo variants because de novo means new. De novo variants happen in the sperm, egg, or during an individual's development. Using the same example, if neither parent has a variant that causes Duchenne muscular dystrophy, but their child has a variant that causes Duchenne muscular dystrophy, the child has a de novo or new variant. Sometimes a variant is found in only some of a person's cells. This is called mosaicism. Mosaicism can happen when a change to the DNA occurs during development. As a result, only a portion of the individual's cells have the variant and the rest of the cells do not contain the variant. An individual who is mosaic for a variant associated with a condition, also called a pathogenic variant, may show no symptoms, mild symptoms, or severe symptoms depending on how many cells are mosaic and where those mosaic cells are in the body. For example, if mosaic cells are in a person's muscles, they may experience muscle weakness, whereas if the individual's mosaic cells are in the kidneys, they may not show severe symptoms. Mosaicism can also occur in an individual's sperm or eggs. When a variant is only found in sperm or eggs, this is called germline mosaicism. Current genetic testing technology does not detect germline mosaicism. Germline mosaicism can be identified if two siblings are found to have the same variant, but neither parent has that variant. When someone has germline mosaicism, they do not have symptoms associated with the variant, but they have a chance of having children with the variant in all of the child's cells. Thank you for watching our video. If you have questions, please reach out to your healthcare provider or contact Genome Connect. We hope you join us for our other videos.